Hello, welcome again. In this video, I shall be discussing the flow of data into the BI system. Up until now, we have discussed the structure of the warehouse and actually how the warehouse stores data and how it is administered for efficiency. So now we are getting closer to the real world practical stuff, actually bringing in data from real world examples into the system and making it available for reporting later. So before we start, we need to know some things, and the first thing is how the data makes it into the SAP system, and also the journey our data takes before it is stored in the BI server. So first of all, the process of extracting data and making it useful for our needs and storing it is called ETL. So that is extraction, transformation, and loading. That is what ETL stands for. So extraction has to do with retrieving information from a source system. This source system can be of various types, because SAP supports a lot of different source systems, from databases to classic SAP ERP systems, and also Excel flat files. You can also get data from web services as well. The data is actually extracted by the data source and then temporarily saved in the PSA. The PSA is the persistent storage area. There are actually a lot of three-letter abbreviations in SAP. This is not the last one you're going to hear. So data sources are actually business intelligence objects that are used to extract and stage data from source systems. After the data source extracts the data, it is stored in a transparent database called the PSA. Normally, we would use one PSA, that's a persistent storage area. So normally, we would use one PSA per data source or source system. So the three objects that we should take into consideration while extracting are source systems, data sources, and the PSA. So after extraction comes transformation. The data needs to be cleansed and transformed into useful information before we actually store it in the target. The objects used to create transformations are called info sources. Transformation rules are set on the fields of the info sources to replicate business data. Here is where the fields in the source system are actually transformed or converted to fields in the target or destination. Our destinations in this case will be info cubes. Info sources can also be used for multi-step transformations or to map multiple data sources to one target or info provider. After transformation, the data is then loaded into our info providers. This BI object, which we have actually discussed a lot in our previous lessons, is basically the storage point of the BI server where our business data resides and ready for queries to be made of it. So there are two processes that make the ETL process happen. One is called the info package. The second is the DTP. DTP stands for data transfer process. These two come in at different times to actually manage the data transfer process in terms of scheduling and also administration. So first of all, the info package takes care of the first stage where we load data from the source system. And then it triggers the call to the source system to actually extract and load the data and load the information into our PSA, that is the persistent storage area. And then after our data is loaded, the DTP now comes in and pushes the data from the data source through the transformation by the info source. The DTP pushes the data from the data source, and then it is now transformed by the info sources, which we talked about earlier. And after that, it is now stored in the info provider. So normally you would have one data transfer process or DTP per info provider. So that is it for this lesson. We have discussed the flow of data through the BI server, all the way from extraction from the source system through to transformation, and then finally loading it into our target or info provider. We have also discussed about the objects that are actually involved in this process. So those are the data sources, info sources, PSA. And we have also discussed the objects responsible for making it happen, namely the info package and the data transfer process, DTP. So in later lessons, we will take a practical look by extracting some real-world data and taking it through the ETL process, all the way to storing this information in the BI info providers. So thank you for listening. See you in the next video.